Hi friends, welcome back. Today video session we are going to talk about some web service implementation. Learning web service is very easy using Spring Boot. Let's see how it's going. See this, you should know some common web service terminology, which is what is HTTP header, what is HTTP request, what is HTTP response methods and status code. And there are some Spring Boot annotations. You should know about those annotations. Through that annotation only we can implement web service. Okay, now we're going to see the implementation. Go to start.spring.io website. Now I'll go to create a one project here. The project group name is com.idgarden artifact stock management. I'll going to start with stock management. I don't want to say some hello world examples. I want to give some projects. Okay. I taken that project as a stock management. Okay. Step by step, this project we can improve. This is the first web service implementation session. In this session, we are going to see very basic implementations. My project name is stock management. Then, package name is com.idgarden. Dependencies, what is dependency? Web. Spring Web, we have to add as a dependency to implement a web service. Now you have to generate a project. It's generating as a stock management. I want to save here. Okay, saved as a zip file. Extract that zip file. I'll remove that. Extract here. Do extract here. Now the project basic structure is generated. Now IntelliJ is opening now. Now I want to import that project which I generated. Wait for a few minutes. Okay, close it. File, new project from existing source. I imported in this location. I created a project in this location which is stock management. The stock management, select that. Then select pom.xml file. Once you select the pom.xml file, project will going to create. It will ask, do you want to open this project this window or new window? I always prefer new window. Project is importing. Okay, project got imported. Stock management application, class creator. Now I want to create a few more packages. File, new package, controller package. In this controller package, I'm going to create one class called stock management controller. This class acts as our web service class. In this class only, we're going to add, we are going to create all our endpoint. If you want to act this class as a REST web services, we need to say REST controller. At REST controller is an annotation. Using this controller, we can enable particular class as a web service class. Through this class only, we can create a endpoint URL. Using that endpoint, we can access particular method from client side. Now, I want to create a one simple method called get mapping. Public string display. Return. This is simple web service example. If you want to create a endpoint, we need to use some annotations. See here, get mapping, post mapping, put mapping, delete mapping, and a request mapping. Using these annotation, we can create different type of annotations. Now I am creating an endpoint which is a get mapping, which is a get endpoint. If you want to create a get endpoint, we need to use at get mapping annotation. In class level, I am going to use them at request mapping. Here I am saying API slash products. Since we are going to start stock management, I am giving here products and the API. API, since we are developing an API, I am giving them API slash whatever resource you want access. After API, I want to access the resource called products. I want to access the products information. Once access the information, I can manipulate that information. So this is a general common path for the endpoint which I am going to create. Okay. This is a simple endpoint. I am going to check it's working or not. Now I'll say display. Now I'm going to start my application. Right click, run. My application started. Now I'm going to invoke this particular endpoint. To invoke this endpoint, what I have to do? We have to use a HTTP protocol. HTTP colon localhost. This application running under 8080. So I am using 8080 slash. I want to access this display endpoint, display method. So I need to use this mapping. Display. This can be anything. This mapping values can be anything. Okay, you can use even print. I am using a print here. Okay, this is the annotation, this is the path, this is called as a endpoint. This is called as a endpoint. Endpoint nothing but it's a URL. Using that URL, you can access particular method from your REST controller class. Now I'll go into access this method, invoke this method using this endpoint. Now I've already started this. Since I changed the display to print, I want to restart the application. You can start like this, start, you can say, or you can say, run. I've given debug, but I will explain later what is debug. Let's see, it started. Yeah, started. What is the URL? This is the URL, right? Localhost 8080 slash print. Should not use that print. I made a mistake. The common path is the class level. I have given API slash products, right? We need to give that also. http://localhost/api/products/print. We have to give like this. So this is simple web service example. Okay. Still I have not started the product stock management. Just I verified the created web service application working or not. This is working perfectly. From now on, we are going to implement some endpoint which is required for a stock management. Okay. Let's see how to implement a very simple stock management. This video focuses, you need to understand web service implementation, how to create a web service, how to create a endpoint. You should become good knowledge on a web service. That is a focus on this video, not for stock management functionality. So I'm going to give very minimal functional implementation, but you will get understand very clearly about the web services. Okay. Now to implement a simple stock management, you need to create a one model class, that is a product model class. This is a simple Java class. In the Java class, I created a four attributes: product ID, product name, product price, product stock count. Four attribute. It has a respective setter and getter method. In the stock management controller, I'm going to create a one endpoint. It's a get endpoint only. Get mapping. Using get mapping, I'm going to create a get endpoint. Using get mapping, I'm going to get a get endpoint, which is nothing, which is nothing, just empty parameter. I will explain why. Public list product list product get all products. Return products. Sorry. List product. Products equal to new array list. Since I am not using any database, I am going to manipulate this stock in the products array list. I hope you know about array list, because this video should applicable only for who knows the code Java. Okay. I'm using this object as a database. Now I'm not using any real database. This particular get all products return all products that is stored in this products collection, product array list. Okay, if you want to access this particular endpoint, what you'll do, just http://localhost/8080/api/products, that's it. Since I have not given anything, if you say products, this will return all products that are available from the database. In our case, it's coming from array list. Next endpoint is, I want to view particular product, not all. In that case also, you need to use get mapping. Product ID. All you have to do is add a path variable, public product get product, I want to get the product ID from this product list, right? I want to get that particular product. For that, product dot stream dot filter p dot get product id dot equals of product id. Here in this get product method, I want to pass a path variable as a parameter. Since this here in the get mapping, instead of get mapping, I am passing within braces product ID. This meaning this is a path variable. Whenever you access the particular endpoint, you need to pass that product ID part of the endpoint. Okay. So this whatever value you are passing it, that value come to your get product method parameter. For that, you have to say at path variable long product ID. Okay, now I want to match whatever product ID coming here. I want to match the product ID inside this collection, inside this product collection. Product dot equals find any dot get. This is a lambda expression. Using this lambda expression, I am finding the product ID coming from the path variable. If that product ID matches with this product collection, I am returning that product here. Return product. Okay. These are getting particular product from the collection of products array list. Now I want to add. I would have implement the first add method. Instead I implemented a get method. Now we're going to add a add method. For add, we need to use a post mapping. If you want to post something from the client side to server side, we need to use a post method. To implement a post method, the Spring Boot provide one annotation called post mapping. Post mapping, I'm going to say add public void add product now. From the client side, they are sending some product information, right? That product information I want to access here. For that, there is a one annotation called request body. Request body, then whatever information coming from the client side, that type we need to declare here. Product. So they are going to pass the product information in the form of product object. So I am declaring product as a request body, okay? Once this whenever user post that product information through this add product method, the product information populated in product object. Here I'm going to initialize my array list. Product if, I'll remove this as a null here. We can initialize also, but I'm going to keep null. Okay, if products equal to null, what I will do, products equal to new array list, then products dot add product, that's it. I think you should understand this logic. If you want to add a product, I want to use add endpoint. Whenever user calls this endpoint, they should pass product information part of the request body. That request body contains product detail. That product detail I'll going to add in my products array list. If the products array list is a null, I'll going to initialize. Now we have implemented three endpoint. One is get add product, another one is showing all products, another one is viewing particular products. That's it. Here we need to pass, we need to use like this add product slash add. Here we have to say just product slash ID, whatever ID you want, whatever ID available. Okay. Okay, now we're going to see the demo. Going to run now. In that, right click, run. Now server is started now. So I'm going to invoke those endpoint. Previously I used the browser, right? Okay, I used the browser through get mapping. I can easily access that particular endpoint through browser. Now I want to add some product. How do you do that? There are many clients. We should not use browser. Better to use some tool, web service client tool. We need to use. There is one of the famous tool called Postman. Postman, you can download, it's free only. You can download this Postman web client, web service client. Postman web service client. You can download this. This is very easy to set up. Installation is very easy. Okay. Just download the exe and click next, that's it. You will get installed. Now I want to use this tool as a client. Okay, I don't have web application. I don't have web interface, right? I want to access this endpoint. I want to access this endpoint through one of the client interface. That client interface act as a Postman. Okay. Now we're going to how to access that. My server is started now. Now I want to show one simple example using Postman. I want to access this endpoint. Here, just click the plus icon. This is not required. Close it. Plus, once click the plus icon, you will get like this interface in the address bar. Just paste that endpoint. I am going to invoke this particular method. This method is a get mapping, so I am using get method. Header, you can say content type. Content type, we got the application.json. Web service by default return the response as a JSON, right? So I'm setting the content type as an application/JSON. After that's it, you configure now. Okay, you have to open this Postman, click the plus icon, you will get this tab. In this tab, add that endpoint, then the header part, you need to say content type equal to application/JSON, then send. Once you send that, the request will go here and then return this information and print here. See here, this is web service example sprinter. Now next example is I want to add a product. For that I need to pass product information from the client side. Let's see how to do that. Create one more tab. Since this is a post mapping, I want to use post. Header is content type. Content type is application.json. Now I want to construct this JSON request, the product. So in this product, how many attributes we have? Product ID, product name, product price, and the product stock count. The four attributes. So what you have to do is here. Go to body, select this raw option, and within the braces we need to take this attribute colon one, take this attribute colon product name is washing powder. Don't do comma and a comma. Then product price is $30. then product stock count. Then, okay, this is the JSON request. This is called the JSON request. JSON request should be follow the structure. The attribute colon value. Attribute colon value. These, since these are number values, I have not enclosed with the double quotes. Okay. This is the procedure you have to follow to construct JSON. Okay. Now I have a constructed the request body. Instead of body option, we need to say you need to construct the request body. That request body should match with whatever Java class you are using here. That is model class using here. That attribute must match here. That's it. Now I want to send this information to my server. When you send this information, when you click send, that meaning you are sending a request from the through postman. That request come here. Now that request are coming as a product object. That product object I am adding to my array list. Okay, let's see what's going on. I click the send button. See here, I am getting some error. Unsupported media type. Sorry, content type I selected wrongly, I think. No. Wait. Yeah, content type I selected wrongly. Instead of selecting JSON, I selected some other thing. JSON. Okay, we have to select. Now, again, I'll go and send the request. See, it gives the error. Unsupported media type. That means whatever the content type you have set. One, but I'm sending as a JSON. Content type I set one type, but I'm sending as a JSON format. That's the reason it's giving the unsupported media type. Now I'll go into set again. See here, status 200 okay means request sent successfully. Okay, now we'll see. I'll add one product here. Let's say one washing powder, product price and the product stock count. Now I want to view that. I want to view all products. For that, we need to use this endpoint, right? Copy this. Paste here. Since it's a get mapping, use get. And the other is content type application / JSON. See here, whatever product I added here, that is coming here. Right, now I'm going to add one more product to rice, Android, then two added. Now using get mapping, I'll going to call this method get all products. See, get products, that mappings this get all product for this get all products mapped with this particular mapping. I have not mentioned anything here, right? Just empty parameter. So you need to say api/product. That's it. I'm using the same here. When you send, it will going to come two products. See, two products. Since already this video went to 30 minutes, I'm stopping here. We will continue to see the web service implementation from next video onwards. Okay. Please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.